My name is Barbara, and I'm here to do a video log. My father recently passed away, December 5th, of brain, lung, and prostate cancer. The youngest is 7, and pretty much the whole entire time, my dad was going through these illnesses. My siblings weren't around, really, just me and my mother. And the typical thing happened that I didn't want to happen. My dad got really, really sick right after Halloween. I'm going to back up my story, actually. He had prostate cancer for about 10 years. And then, I'd say probably around this year, he got really sick right after Halloween. And he pretty much... It was a slow process when he got really sick. His memory got really, really bad. And things that he used to do, he didn't do anymore. I would take him to doctor's appointments, and he didn't remember what happened or why he was there. He couldn't walk that well anymore. And so I pretty much had him go see a specialist, and they said that he had a stroke and he needed to go to the ER. Went to the ER, he went to the OSU hospital, and that's pretty much when we found out he was really, really sick, and he had a brain and lung cancer. And so, it really affected me and my mom. My mother has spent her whole life for 32 years with my dad, and for me, it hurt me. Because I was the last one to leave home, and I'm 31. Recently got engaged, and I don't know. Like, I would still visit even after I moved out, and I would still do things while my siblings did absolutely nothing. And so, life for me after my dad got sick got really, really worse. He was in the hospital. And then they said that they thought he could possibly get surgery. But then there was this guy in the room next to him who said that he shouldn't do surgery and how I needed to check out other, resources or whatever to find out what else could be done. And so I'm glad we didn't do surgery. We just had to do radiation. And right before he did radiation, they thought maybe he should go to a nursing home. That was something me and my mom wasn't really sure we wanted to do. But we put him in a nursing home. He was there for about a month. And actually, the week after he had radiation, that's when he passed away. And I saw my father pretty much go from this strong man to this very small, weak man. And it was just me, my mom, and my fiance. There, and my family has not been the same since. My siblings really haven't been there, and now they're trying their best to be children they should have been before my father passed away. And it's hurt my mom because they are my dad's children from his first marriage, and they're my stepbrothers and sisters. And actually, just me, my mom, like, I'm her only child because she had one father. So you can just imagine how these children who she helped raise are now being enemies to her. Even, right after my father passed away, they pretty much didn't call. They made rude comments and criticized everything he did. And my dad made me power of attorney, so I was pretty much in charge of everything. And my dad's brother, he helped out with the funeral arrangements, and so it hurts now knowing that the people that should have been around are trying to be around now. They're trying to get pictures of my dad, my siblings, and even at the funeral, they were pretty much doing exactly what I thought they would do. But the fact that they ignored my mother at the funeral too hurt me a great deal. So now it's just me and my mom. And I promised my dad that I'll take care of her, and she's doing her best to make sure I'm okay too. It's really sad because I'm getting married next April, and I knew that he probably wouldn't be at the wedding. I knew he probably wouldn't walk me down, which is, I'm gonna have my cousin Andre walk me down, but it would've been nice to have him walk me down. But he was 78, and he walked with a cane, and I'm just glad he was around to see a lot of things that I graduated from college, and he did meet my fiance, and right before he died, he gave his blessing for us to get married. It just hurts me because I'm daddy's little girl, and he's never going to get a chance to see